So guys, I am Deborah Harrison with Simply Sweet and Ink Designs. I'm so glad that you joined me today. I am super excited to share this project with you. It is a really cute, simple Valentine's treat holder, and it uses the Punch Party, which is a host stamp set that you can get free during celebration with either personal orders, because we all got big wish lists, right? Or if you get your friends together and do a party and you have sales of at least $300, then you can get this Punch Party stamp set for free. So I'm gonna set this aside, kind of get it out of my way. And this is the cute little project that we're gonna make today. It is, what I did is I just added some little Dove chocolates inside, and it's super simple. So I'm gonna put this off to the side and we're gonna get started. So you're gonna want to first start off with the 3 1/8 by 3 1/8 acetate box. And those can be found in the packaging section of the catalog. And I'm just gonna assemble my box real quickly. Now I'm not gonna put the treats in just yet. I'll do that later. All right, should I maybe assemble this beforehand? It's giving me a little bit of trouble. There we go. All right, so once I have it assembled, I'm gonna take a 3 by 3 inch piece of the, it's the Love You Always specialty paper. Now I normally, you know me, I like to use my Tombow glue, but I'm not gonna do that this time because that's just gonna make a really big mess and glob on my acetate box. So instead, I'm just gonna use some either snail or any kind of tape adhesive. And we're just gonna put that onto the front of the box. Let me see if I can get that on there. All right. So what we're gonna do next is I'm gonna take a scrap piece of the Blushing Bride cardstock, and I'm gonna take one of the stamps from the Punch Party, and I'm going to just stamp in Blushing Bride. So it's gonna be just kind of like Blushing Bride on Blushing Bride. And then we're just gonna stamp that onto our cardstock. We get that out of the way. And then I'm gonna take my heart punch. Now I wanna use the scalloped heart punch today. And I will tell you, the scalloped heart punch isn't a perfect match for this stamp, but it's really, really close. And it gives just a really nice outline. We're gonna punch that out. And then next, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do something that I have not done on a Facebook Live before. And that is doing some heat embossing. I love heat embossing. But I don't normally do it because I actually am a little bit messy about it. So hopefully I won't make a huge mess today. We'll see. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take just a scrap piece of just paper so that I can keep my area clean. And then what I wanna do is I am going to take my Stamparatus. And the reason I'm using the Stamparatus is because Stampin' Up! Does not currently sell black embossing powder. So if you don't have black embossing powder and you want to be able to do in black or any other color, I'm gonna show you a way that you can do that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a piece of basic white cardstock. I'm gonna use my Stamparatus and hold it down with my magnets. Then I'm gonna take the sentiment from the Punch Party. Now, if you're not familiar with using the Stamparatus, this is gonna be a really, really quick tutorial. So you're gonna place your stamp wherever you think you would like it to be. Then you're gonna take your plate that's on a hinge and you're just gonna press down. And then you're gonna lift it up. And as you see, it just lifted it up. So what's nice is anytime that I want, I can go back and forth and I can get the same placement on my stamp. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my black Memento ink pad first, and I'm going to ink up my stamp. And then we're just gonna stamp the image like we normally do. Okay, I didn't quite like that, so I'm gonna try it again. Like I said, with the Stamparatus, you get to redo, which is what I love about it. So we're gonna try that again. All right, so now what I wanna do is I need to clean this off. Let me grab my chamois real quick. I forgot to grab that, all right. So let me clean off the ink. Now what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna take our VersaMark. But before I do that, I'm gonna take an embossing buddy. Now, this is not available by Stampin' Up! Anymore as well, but you can usually find them at craft stores. It's basically like a little rosin pad, and what it does is it removes any oils that may be left on the paper. So next, what I'm going to do, now that I've done the embossing buddy, kind of tap that onto my cardstock, is I'm going to ink up my stamp again with VersaMark pad. All right, so then we're just going to stamp in the same place. See how I really needed the stamparatus to be able to have it positioned in the exact same spot that I have before. So now what I'm going to do is I should be done here. So I'm going to move my stamparatus out of the way. And now's when I'm going to bring in my scrap piece of paper, because there's what's going to get a little bit messy. I'm going to take clear embossing powder, and we're going to put clear embossing powder on the top here. Close that up so I don't make a mess everywhere. And then just kind of flick off any excess embossing powder. Now, if you have any little bit of strays around, you can just kind of scrape them off with either a little paintbrush or your finger. All right, so next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take the heat tool, and I've already pre-warmed it up so that we can work a little faster. It's gonna get a little loud, so bear with me. And then we're just gonna heat it up until we see that that embossing powder kind of turn shiny. See, it has a really pretty shimmer to it. Hopefully that shows up in the camera. All right, so it looks like I might have done too much here, too high, so I'm gonna need to kind of cut some of this down a little bit so that my punch can fit in there nicely. And now I'm gonna use my punch again, and we're gonna grab the right punch. Now we're gonna use the non-scallop punch, and we're gonna punch out our sentiment. All right. Okay, so now we're just going to kind of assemble everything. Let me get my sample back in here. And what I'm going to do is I want to take my small bloom punch, and I'm just going to punch out a scrap piece of paper, punch a little bloom. And now we're just going to put everything together. So I'm going to tie off my box with this really pretty Blushing Bride metallic ribbon. I already have a piece cut out. And I want to do this first. Of course, naturally, you'd want to put your treats inside before you do that. And I'm just going to tie a bow here at the top. Now, naturally, I'll come back and I'll fix this bow here in a little bit. It's not the prettiest of bows, but hopefully you get the idea. All right. So now what I want to do is I'm going to take and I'm going to glue my embossed piece onto my Blushing Bride scalloped heart. All right, this worked earlier when I was using it, and now it doesn't want to cooperate. Okay, you know what? We're gonna use the backup plan, and we're gonna use our tape. Okay, all right, so let's get those lined up. All right, yay. Okay, so now what you want to do is, because I do have this ribbon here, is I want to take and I want to put a dimensional on each side and allow room for over my ribbon, just kind of bridge that area there. So we're going to put that on the box with a little dimension. Then what I did is I'm going to take my little bloom that I punched out, and I punched these out of the perennial petal dies in the Blushing Bride. I went ahead and I did that ahead of time. And I'm just going to glue that on, or tape it on, I guess, since my glue does not want to cooperate all of a sudden. And we're just going to put that on the middle of my bloom. And then we're going to put a dimensional on the back there. Okay, so what I'm going to do to finish off my project is I'm going to take one of my large black matte dots, and we're just going to put it right there in the middle of my little bloom. And then our project is done. So hopefully everything's good and you were able to see everything great today. So guys, if you were looking for the project sheet, I do have that over on my blog. You can go grab that. It has all the supplies that I used today and all the measurements. And guys, remember, this is celebration. For every $50 you spend, you get a free celebration item. So it's really awesome. Check that out. I want to share with you too the classes I have coming up. My project class for the snail mail, that registration ends on January 31st. You can check out that registration link. Also too, my February Stamp Club registration, I just opened that up yesterday, and you can check that out. The registration deadline is February 6th. And then the Stampin' Bunko. And I do want to show you the Stampin' Bunko project because they're adorable. They use the Sweet Strawberry Bundle and the Berry Blessings Designer Series paper. And the registration for my Stampin' Bunko ends on February 6th as well. So go check those out. But let me show you, before I sign off, let me show you the projects for the Stampin' Bunko. I just thought they're so cute with the little strawberries. So guys, thank you so much for joining me. Hopefully everything went well and you enjoyed today's project. And I will see you next Thursday. Bye, guys.